Hello tennis nerds, this time I wanted to do a tennis vlog. I wanted to talk about rackets and how personal a racket spec can be. And you can see here I have loads of rackets on my desk, rackets I've been trying recently. I just finished a vlog on my Patreon about the different styles of rackets, if going from spin, power, comfort, control, and more of attacking control. There are a bunch of different categories of rackets, and it depends on you as a player, what you like, what style you have, what player level you are, and so on, and the fitness as well. If you have any injuries, you should probably look more into a comfort racket, or at least string it with a softer string setup or a lower tension. So it's very much a personal preference, what you like. Case in point, you might like the V-Core 95, this one from 2019, or you much prefer the new one that was a little bit different, just a little bit stiffer, a little bit different, more muted feel. You might think that one is better, or you might even prefer the SV-95, which is the one that allegedly Denis Shapovalov is using. And this one has a more raw feel, a more direct string bed. I kind of prefer the SV95. It's the kind of the first time I played it. I've been enjoying that one. But I know a lot of players that prefer this one. Marcus Giron on the tour, he plays it in stock form with some, almost in stock form with just some weight. Take Dustin Brown, for example. He plays with a pretty stiff racket with a really high tension poly. That would break most players' arms, but it works for him and his playing style, which is ultra aggressive, going to the net, playing a lot of funky stuff. And then you have players on the WTA Tour that use kind of a pure drive with a full bit of natural gut. That shows how different players and their preferences are. So whatever you want to play with, whatever works for you, use that, do that. And you can't really say, I get some comments sometimes, maybe from trolls, that they say, oh, that racket is garbage, that racket is crap, and that racket is the best racket ever. You can't really make these sweeping statements about rackets, because it might be garbage to you. And I'm pretty sure it's not a garbage racket. There will be people who really like that racket. There will be people that dislike that racket. So stating that a racket is garbage or a racket is the best ever is pretty immature, in my opinion, because it's not how it works. There are rackets that I dislike strongly that some players swear by, and so on. And a case in point, I wanted to showcase my buddy Estoy, who is a good player. He hits the ball like Andrei Rublev. He's from the Philippines, so I call him the Rublev from Makati, which is the place he's from. Really takes a huge swipe at the ball, manages to control it as well. And he's a coach at the Arshak Academy here in Malta. And I had a training session with him and Matthew, and yeah, I was pretty impressed by the amount of power he gets. He really likes the Blade 98 version 6, the one with countervail. I've been hating a bit on that one. I am not a huge fan of countervail technology. I think it muted the feel too much, and I much prefer the version 7, which felt a bit more connected, a bit softer, a bit more like a kind of prestige style racket. But he, when we discussed it, he hated it, so he didn't like that at all. And that shows how different you can be. That, I mean, he likes the version 6 with that Solinco Hyper G, and that's what he wants to play with. And for me, that would not be a good choice. I wouldn't like the feel too much of that. Some players might love a prestige, while guys like Matthew I'm hitting with, he is a huge fan of the Pure Aero VS. Now that's become his racket of choice. So personal preferences, that's what it's all about. You might love a racket, you might hate a racket. You need to really give rackets time when you test them. You need to make sure that you understand what the string gives to the racket. Is the string bad? Is the string making the racket play worse? It makes a big difference what string you have in it. So when you demo, make sure that you understand how the string impacts the frame. Otherwise, if you can restring it, if you can't, well, you might have to take a chance and buy it or not buy it based on that. But that's always a thing. When I'm testing all these rackets, I usually try to use a string I know. And if I'm testing a string, I use a racket I know, so I understand what difference it is. I think that's very important to get an idea of how a racket plays. In many ways, I play better with very stiff frames, like stiffer string beds, like a Pure Drive from 2009 that's down here. But my arm says, no thank you, so then I have to find some kind of compromise of that. Now I've been enjoying the Ripsticks, as I've said in previous videos. Might not be the racket I'm the most confident with, because it does add a lot of power, and I might end up with the Prestige MP or a Synergy 98, for example. When it comes to rackets, personal preferences might also change, so you might be liking Pure Aero, and you're playing good tennis with that, that seems to suit your style, but then maybe you know advance a level or something happens, or you just start feeling too stiff for you, then you have to change. Maybe you change to a Clash, or maybe you go and play with a Technifiber TF40 instead and start playing with more control. You want a more controlled frame and a different style of racket. So personal preferences, it's not if a racket is garbage or great. You have a playing style, you have a playing level, the level might change, the style might change, your technique might change, and with that, the racket you're playing with might need to change to optimize your tennis. The racket is definitely not everything, but it does make a difference, so it's good to keep that in mind with how you want to play your game and how your game evolves, because the idea is obviously that you want to improve. You want to get more out of your tennis, and then the racket can help, or it can kind of put you down. So that's why it makes a difference what racket you play with. Some musings about tennis rackets here on a Friday afternoon. I've been playing really bad tennis lately. Have some arm issues that I need to sort out. Not been happy with my game, so that's my. And I've been testing a bunch of different rackets just for these kind of video purposes and reviews. Hope to be able to get back to playing more regularly with one frame, so I get into the groove of that, and then that will hopefully resolve my arm issues a little bit. So don't play with too many rackets, try to have a setup that you like and that works for you. And then you can play around from time to time, but it's good to have your standard setup. That would be my recommendation. So, it's all personal preferences. What racket and string setup do you like? Why do you like it? Please comment below. I'm really keen to hear your thoughts. Also, if you're interested in doing like a live Q&A on YouTube, where you can ask questions live, and we talk about rackets and strings and whatnot. Please let me know in the comments below. I'll happily set something up in a suitable time zone, hopefully for as many as possible. If you need help choosing a racket, check out Tennis Nerd Consultations. I do them via video call or email, depends on what you like. There are two options there on tennisnerd.net. If you want to support Tennis Nerd and get more content, you become a patron, patreon.com/tennisnerd. And if you want to check me out on my other social media, you can go to Tennis Nerd Insta on Instagram. There's also a Facebook group and a Facebook page, as well as a Twitter account. So there's a bunch of ways to keep up to date with Tennis Nerd. Please also subscribe to the newsletter. That's all for this one. Have a nice weekend. I will talk to you soon. And don't forget to play some tennis.